Now, a long shot for a long shot. July 1st, 2020. Hong Kong police briefly detained a man in a Liverpool Football Club t-shirt who shouted, "Long live Liverpool!" during anti-government protests on Wednesday. According to In Media, the football fan, Mr. Watt, was across the street from police officers who were conducting stop and searches on a group of protesters when he shouted, "Long live Liverpool!" Others reportedly cheered and joined in the chant before officers detained him. Watt told reporters that police had accused him of inciting Hong Kong independence, a now punishable crime under the newly enacted national security laws, which came into effect late on Tuesday night. Watt said that he had been a fan of the English football team for the past 30 years and felt an irrepressible urge to voice his feelings over their recent Premier League championship before exclaiming yet again, "Long live Liverpool!"
Kristen Nyampenta once shared a story that Rwandans used song as gravestones before there was a need for memorialization sites that came after the genocide. He wondered the impact of this on the collective body. South Africans used the ancestral lines as a way of introduction, a sort of generational biography. Sonically, nodding to what is out of sight, but embodied. The body becomes a hard drive. A stain or a mark has been left. What is out of sight persists in different forms, gathering momentum to resurface.